In this tutorial, you'll learn how easy it is to add a variety of instant effects to your images in PaintShop Pro. You'll learn all about the different filter categories you can choose from, how to apply instant effects to a photo, and how to combine multiple instant effects to create a truly unique image. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along. Let's get started. A really quick way to try out the most popular instant effects is to click on the Crop tool. Then click and hold down on the Instant Effects icon, and then you can click on the various filters to try them out. I'm going to choose the BW Clarify effect. Then click on the green check icon to both apply the effect and crop my image. To access the full collection of Instant Effects filters, click on Palettes at the top, and then select Instant Effects. First, I'm going to adjust the margin of the palette by clicking on the edge and dragging it to the left so that the preview image is larger and I can test out different effects. From here, we can click on the drop-down menu from the Instant Effects palette and see all of the different filter categories available to choose from. The Artistic section contains effects that make images look like drawings, paintings, and other works of art. Next, there is a section dedicated entirely to black and white filters. The Film Styles category contains a variety of effects to make it look like your photos were taken in a different time period or era. The Landscape effects are best used to change the look and feel of outdoor shots. You can use Portrait effects to fix or enhance photographs of people and faces. Retro effects add dynamic color changes to transform the feel of your image. And traditional effects are a quick way to apply commonly used filters, such as brightness, contrast, or vignettes to an image. I have this photograph of a Sicilian landscape opened up, so I'm going to try out some filters under the Landscape Effects category. You can click once on any effect in the category and see how it will change the way the image looks in the preview pane. To apply an effect, just double-click on it, and it will now be applied to your image. Now let's say I want to undo this and add a different effect instead. Just click on Undo. Then I can double-click on the Contrast More effect that I really like, and now I'm happy with my image. You can also add multiple effects to the same image to really produce a unique style and feel to your photographs. I have opened up a portrait of a woman, so I'm going to click on the Portrait Effects category. I want to brighten up this image, so I'm going to double-click on the Smart Photo Fix P2 effect. Now I want to add a second effect, so I'm going to go to the Retro category and double-click on the Retro Green effect. By adding these two filters, I've completely changed the way the picture looks. And now the colors are really vibrant and her eyes really pop in the portrait. Finally, I want to show you how you can apply instant effects to a selection instead of to your entire image. I have this image of some red roses, and I want to make one of the roses really stand out from the rest of the image. I'm going to quickly click on the Smart Selection Brush tool and click to brush over the flower to select it. Then I'll click on the Palettes tab and then Layers. Next, I'll click on Selections, then Promote Selection to Layer to make the flower as its own layer. Then go back to Selections and click Select None. So now, under the Layers palette, I'm going to click on the background image because I want to add the effect just to the background. Now I'll go to the black and white category and double-click on BW Clarify High. And with this effect, now you can see the red rose really stands out against the black and white background. To really make the rose stand out, I can click on the rose layer from the layers palette. Then go to the Retro category and double-click on Retro Dark. And now you'll see I have a beautiful image of a really crisp dark red rose against a black and white background. These are just some of the many ways you can have fun creating beautiful, unique images using the many instant effects available in PaintShop Pro. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find other helpful tutorials for PaintShop Pro.